Woo! It is 6:15 on October 5th, and I'm feeling pretty good because I just left work, and I'm off tomorrow. So, plan is to go home. I'm going to shoot some bow a little bit. Definitely like to shoot my bow as much as possible during this season. So I'm going to shoot a bit, and then I'm going to pack things up because tomorrow at 1:30 in the morning, I'm meeting Mitch, and we're going to hunt Sika deer on the eastern shore of Maryland. Next time you see me, it'll probably be pretty early tomorrow morning, and we will be heading for the shore. See you then. Pulled over here to this parking lot to take a little nap before going in this evening for Sika. And I just got a call about an hour ago. My grandfather died. He was an amazing guy. And he's the one that taught me a lot about the outdoors. He's also the person that taught me that hard work's often rewarded. Shortcuts just don't really get you anywhere. So tonight's gonna be the first time I ever went in the woods. Without being able to come out and tell my pap how I made out. So hopefully tonight goes good. This one's for you, Pap. Really not just this hunt today, but this whole season. Good morning. It is about 1:45 in the morning right now, and Tim and I are on our way to the eastern shore to chase Sika deer for a couple days. I'm gonna try to be the early birds here this morning, get to our spots, and hopefully it also helps the other hunters to push deer our way come, near dawn anyway. So, we will see you guys here down at the marsh.
Muzzleloader season. You can hear that mud motor. That's out in the marsh further. I'm a little higher up the tree today. I came probably about 30 feet up only because I want to get elevation to be able to see down into this marsh a little better. There's a lot of stuff that's around that 2-3 foot high mark, and then the water's about a foot deep, so those deer really melt into the floor of this marsh. And getting elevation should give me some shooting down into it a little better. Hopefully can fill a Sika tag today. That's the plan. is about 95 yards. I shot, all I could see was smoke for like 7 seconds probably. So I couldn't even see anything over there. I can't tell what happened. I didn't hear him crash or run at all. So I'm hoping he just dropped. I really am. I don't know.
Something that's good to do is use my phone, take a picture where I last saw that stag. Alright, now when I go down there, it might be easier to find it. It's tough in this marsh. You aren't gonna believe this, but I didn't see my stag from here. I just was glassing down there, and I'm pretty sure I see him. Check this out.
There he is. Right there.
Yes!
Look at that. I see forks. I see at least forks.
Yeah.
His eye guards are pretty good.
Now I'm gonna get down and see him, and I gotta get that hind too. I'm gonna have a heck of a pack out of those marsh today. Gosh, two freaking deer. The main line this morning. All before probably 8 o'clock.
Yes! Look at that. Look at that. Yeah! What a great stag. That's awesome.
Yes, technically it's almost like a 6-point. I don't know, maybe 5, what do you call it? I'm not sure.
Yeah, look at that. Yeah, yeah! Yes! That's awesome! I just dropped him here.
Well, pretty much, I guess.
I'm so pumped. Look at it.
Beautiful. I mean, look how big they are. These stags are so much bigger than those hinds.
Now I gotta go find that hind. I took a picture where that thing dropped too, so I'm gonna be sure to find that now. We'll get these things both together and get them out of here. All right, here's this hind. Heck of a 70-yard freehand shot.
Yep, right there.
That's so awesome.
I am pumped.
All right, here we are. What a morning in the marsh. Wow. At first light, I had this hind came in, and she gave me about a 70, 75-yard shot. And I was a little concerned because I'm not the best shot with a gun, but it was freehand. But I shot, and she ran about probably 40 yards and just fell over. And I was still kind of celebrating. I reloaded my gun in case she got up. And I kind of just feeling good about life because I shot this hind. And about 5 minutes later, I heard a splash behind me. And I turned around, and I saw this big black body coming through the grass back there. And ended up being this nice, nice 5-point. I am so pumped up with this. What a great morning. He's got nice eye guards. Almost a 6-point up top here. But what a great morning in the marsh. I've hunted these things probably 4 or 5 times this year with my bow. Had some real nice close calls on a couple decent stags. Saw a real nice stag a couple days ago, but it was before daylight. But anyway, got the inline today for the first day of the muzzleloader season and came down here. Got back in one of these spots that I seemed to be pretty well in, and it worked out. Earlier this year, I got a call while I was actually down here hunting Sika deer. I hunted the morning, and I was trying to take a nap in the middle of the day, and it was my dad calling me to tell you my grandfather passed away. And it's pretty hard because between him and my dad, they're probably the two main people that got me into hunting. And it really sucks to not be able to call him right now and just tell him about today, because that's what I used to do. I'd call him and tell him how my day went, especially when I did well. And I guess I can feel kind of good knowing that he's looking down on me. And he probably has a big old smile on his face, because he always did when I would tell him or show him how I made out or show him pictures. What a great day in the marsh. It's also going to be hard to get these things out of here today. I'm way back in here. But I'm just so thankful.
All right, got the stag gutted, hind quartered up, well, actually cut up in bags. So I'm going to start out of here. Thanks again for watching this hunt. Hope you enjoyed it. And hope you have a great, safe, successful season out there in the woods this year. Take it easy.